Joining us now via Zoom, we have Kapamilya actress Liza Soberano and her lawyer, attorney Juanito Lim Jr. Good morning to both of you. Liza, good morning.
Morning, Ms. Karen.
Morning, Ms. Karen.
All right. I'll start with Liza. You have taken a proactive step to protecting your rights. What led you to do this, given that so many celebrities, public personalities, are maligned on social media, and oftentimes, frankly, we just let it pass?
Yeah, the reason why this is so important to me is because I think for the longest time, all of us public figures and celebrities have been accustomed to just, you know, letting things pass. If someone bashes us, we just let it go because we understand that everybody has their own opinions and that because we're public figures that we should just, you know, allow everybody to say what they want to say about us without batting an eye. But now that the issue here is rape, I don't think that I can just let that pass, because for me, the reason why I wanted to pursue this case is because I wanted to take a stand for all the silent victims of rape jokes, of misogyny. And I feel like it's about time that it ends, because rape is not funny. There's nothing funny about joking about it.
All right. Attorney, would you like to chime in? How did you and Sarah, Liza, discuss this before you went to court?
Yes. Well, as Liza's already stated, she's a public figure. Discussed to Liza the consequences of these complaints. But as Liza stated also, rape jokes are not laughing matters. We understand that we have the right to speak. It is constitutionally guaranteed. But we should also remember that our right to speak is not an absolute right. We must draw the line somewhere, sometime.
Okay. Liza, you believe you have a strong case against this netizen?
Yes, I do, because, well, there's nobody you can really pinpoint in those comments but me, because I was the only person at the time to have talked about their company online and to show some disappointment with the service being provided.
Yeah.
So I feel like it's pretty obvious that it was me that they were talking about without even mentioning my name.
All right. Now, there are two cases, I believe you can correct me, that you either have filed or will file. One is against the employee of that company for the rape remark. And is it the same employee who revealed personal info of your stepmother when you actually complained about the internet service? What happened there? Can you explain?
No, they're actually two different people. And we will be doing something about the data privacy violation as well. It's just that I had to take action on this other matter first, because there's more of an urgency for it for me.
Are you able to identify these two people, attorney, or they are in accounts using fake names?
Right now, Karen, we have to rely on whatever resources that we have.
Okay.
For one, it would appear that these personalities have identified themselves clearly, but we are also considering other measures, like probably tapping the assistance of the NBI or the PNP for purposes of ascertaining their identities.
So is it right to say that this employee who made the rape remark on that particular thread online, Liza, attorney, you don't know who this person is yet, or you have a name, you know how this person looks, you've identified her?
Yes, we do. We have the name, we have the picture of these persons. Yes, we have that.
Okay. And you know that she exists. In other words, it's the identity matches let's say, the personal files in that particular company.
Yes, we have reasonable basis to believe that the perpetrator of this rape remark is one and the same.
All right. Now, Liza, what's interesting is this all started with you just complaining, frankly, about bad internet service.
Exactly. And that's why I don't understand why that complaint merited that kind of reaction. I feel like it was very uncalled for, and I'm just afraid that if they can do that to me, they can do that to anyone. Mm-hmm. And because not everyone has the same privilege or opportunity, they won't be able to complain about it or to report it or to talk about it because of fear or because of financial circumstances. And that's why I wanted to become like the stepping stone to help people gain the courage to talk about it, to stand up for themselves, mm-hmm. and also kind of instill fear towards netizens who aren't really being that respectful online nowadays. I think since the pandemic happened, everybody's online, and I've been seeing a lot of people just showing so much hate. Mm. And I want them to all learn a lesson that you can't just bully people online and not and just get away with it.
Yeah. Now, your courage, it's a double-edged sword. You have mm-hmm. some celebrities, Liza, that don't want to get into any kind of controversy. They want everything rosy. But here you are, I'd like to say, I went through your Twitter page last night, and you're quite active even on social issues. Where did this come from, Liza? You've taken a stand on so many social issues.
I think it comes from, I think, more of napupuno na po ako. Before, I wasn't the type to talk about such issues, but I've always had my fair share of opinions on them. I just didn't feel comfortable with sharing them because I knew that people would always have something to say against my opinion. And before, I wasn't comfortable with that. But now, I think I've gained so much courage from seeing other people stand up for themselves. And that has inspired me to start standing up for myself and to start speaking on behalf of those who cannot do so.
Yeah, because what's interesting, I'll start first with this, is during the ABS-CBN franchise hearings, it's quite interesting that your tweets, you were quite vocal in showing your support for ABS-CBN, calling the congressmen to be fair and also protect the jobs of the employees. And not a lot of your colleagues did that.
Mm-hmm. I've always been the type to really stand up for the people I love. A lot of people know that. Like, even when it comes to bashing, I can tolerate anything that is said to me, any hate that is pointed towards me. But when it's the people that I love that they talk about, and in this case, it was ABS-CBN, I truly deeply love the company that I work for and all of its employees. I couldn't just sit back and not do anything about it. I knew that my voice has some power, and I knew that I needed to help in even the smallest way that I could.
Yeah. Now, in relation to ABS-CBN, before I go to your other issues, I'm curious. I know that you've had offers from many other outfits already, and yet you choose to stay with ABS-CBN. Tell me what you've been going through.
Well, that is true. I have received offers and I'm grateful for them. But I told my manager, Tito Oji, that for now I want to be here and support ABS-CBN, especially at a time like this. I think what they need is unity, and they need to see that they are supported by the people that have been there with them since the beginning. And I have nothing but respect for everybody at ABS-CBN, and I just want to continuously support them because I believe that one day we'll be back up and stronger and better than ever.
You don't have fears, Liza. I know I've met many celebrities, and also, of course, coming from the news department, I've spoken to several reporters and anchors as well. Fear is a very normal emotion in terms of the future. It's unknown for all of us. How do you manage your fears?
Faith and trust in the company, and I'm trying to work extra hard, like outside of the company. I know that there are struggles right now, but I'm also trying to find other sources of like financial income, of ways to better myself, and you know, find other opportunities out there outside of showbiz.
In terms of bettering yourself, I found out, tell me if it's true, that you're taking are you finishing psychology now?
Yes, I'm in college right now, and I'm almost finished with my first year.
Okay. Would you want to share with us? So I'm presuming you did you do this before the pandemic or during the pandemic?
I actually started going back to college about over a year ago, but then when I started having a teleserye, I became busy, so I wasn't able to really focus on my studies. It would be like a once a month thing or a twice a month thing. But since the pandemic started, I had more of an opportunity to go to somewhat a regular class or a regular schedule for my class. So yeah, I started like mid quarantine.
And why psychology?
Before, I wanted to take it as a pre-law, but now I don't want to go into law anymore. So just psychology. I want to become a psychologist.
Okay. Would you consider running for public office? I'm curious.
No, I don't think so.
Okay. All right. Going back to your Twitter, a woman of boldness and courage, let me say this. You also, when President Duterte pardoned Pemberton, you also had a very strong tweet about that. You said, So a murderer was just released for good conduct. Are we supposed to just forget that he killed Jennifer Laude because he's done some good? That's a very strong tweet. And you had the hashtag justice for Jennifer Laude, justice trans lives matter. Now, some managers would tell their stars, don't even go there. That's very political. The president has the prerogative to pardon, frankly, anyone under the Constitution.
Yes, my manager did talk to me about that after, but it was more of like he was checking in on me to see if I was okay with all the bashing that I received after it. But it was important for me to speak up about that because I work with a lot of let's say like transgenders or people of that sort. And I felt that I have so much respect for them and love for my glam team, for my manager, for the people that I work in this industry. And I couldn't just let that issue pass also because it's something that was important to me. And as a psychology student, I couldn't really understand too why that case was dismissed when there's so many other cases that haven't even been brought into daylight to be discussed about when there's such lighter cases. And why is this one being focused on? Yeah. Why was he released when he was guilty of the act?
Okay, so the thing is, I'm sure you've gotten a different feedback coming from that. How did you deal with the bashing? Did it actually affect how you wanted to voice out your opinion? Because what happens with bashing and trolls is the aim is to control you and silence you and sometimes even insult you. I'm sure you've gotten feedback saying, Liza, what do you know? Artista ka lang, wag ka na magsalita. And this actually affects some celebrities not to share their thoughts.
I honestly do have times when I feel like, oh, I'm not going to talk about this because they're just going to get mad at me and they're going to bash me. But then again, like you said, their aim is to silence me. And if I give them that, then they win. And we can't let them win. We have to keep on voicing our opinions, especially if we know we're on the right side. And I have to be the voice for the voiceless. Like I said earlier, I have to spark courage to the people that support me and look up to me.
And you don't fear it may alienate some fans? I'm just thinking of how some artists and managers think. You don't have those fears?
I honestly have never thought about that. If they do alienate me, then that means that they never really loved or supported me to begin with.
Yeah. Okay. Now, in the United States and even in many Western countries, celebrities use their popularity specifically to voice out social issues, right? I mean, they even actually endorse a candidate freely or politically. They're quite clear on where they stand. And I won't go there with you, but I'll ask you this. You've reposted about the death penalty. Is Liza Soberano against the death penalty or for the death penalty?
I am against it. For reason being that there are so many people that are incarcerated without being proven guilty. I mean, they are guilty. They are charged as guilty, but there is not enough proof. They may be innocent. And what if one of those people that are actually really innocent end up dying just because they're blamed?
Oo. Go on.
And I just, at a time like this, I didn't expect for that to come up when so many people are already dying because of the coronavirus. I didn't think that they would be prioritizing that.
I'm curious, were you ever asked about your stand on divorce?
On the, sorry?
Were you ever asked about your stand on divorce?
No, I was never asked.
And where do you stand on divorce?
Divorce, that's actually more trickier for me because it depends on the situation of each person. For me, if either of the wife or husband is a victim of abuse, then I am for it. But for lighter reasons, maybe not. Mm-hmm. I'm still conflicted between whether I'm pro-divorce or not.
Okay. Now, what's interesting about you is you clearly you have clarity of thought and integrity mm-hmm. of thought. You know what you want. Mm-hmm. Do you have a role model in show business? Was there someone that inspired you to speak out?
Here in the Philippines, it would definitely be Ate Angel Locsin. In the Western side, I really look up to Audrey Hepburn and Angelina Jolie.
Okay. After speaking out, you've taken it a step further. You've gone to court. What if this netizen apologizes mm-hmm. to you, says, Liza, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. I was at fault. Would you drop mm-hmm. the charges? Attorney,
honestly,
you
yes.
can, you would, okay.
Yes.
Attorney, you can chime in, but go ahead, Liza.
What I really want is for her to say sorry with my name, because I feel like just saying sorry publicly, I don't feel the sincerity, and I feel like she really isn't owning up to her mistake if she does not mention my name in her apology, mm-hmm. because it's so easy to deny that it was me because my name wasn't there. But then again, everything that they were talking about all pointed towards me.
Mm. Attorney, what's your advice?
Personally, I think it would be premature to discuss settlement at this time, simply because we have just filed a case before the prosecutor's office. Just to clarify, Ms. Carino,
sure.
we filed a complaint prosecutor of Quezon City before the Deputy City Prosecutor Irene Resurrection. It is not yet filed in court as of now.
Okay.
With regard to possible settlement, it may not happen, depending on the circumstances, depending on what would the respondent say to Liza. But my advice for now is we do not discuss any settlement matters as of the moment.
All right. Well, I'm happy, attorney, that you're here on the show with us. Okay.
Thank you.
Liza, I know you have to go at 8:20 because you are leaving. I think you're going abroad tonight. So I want to thank you for saying yes to this interview. But I'm just curious, some quick questions for your fans. You had a meeting with Star Cinema recently. Will you be already doing a film by October? Can you share that with us a bit?
Yes, I did have multiple meetings with Star Cinema and also with other executives in ABS, and they have pitched multiple stories actually to me and Enrique. By October, I won't be doing anything yet, but early next year, definitely.
Okay, so nothing this year, early next year. How are you and Enrique, by the way?
We're doing very well, thank you.
Is he flying with you tonight?
Yes, he is.
All right, vacation. I'm just curious, while I'm at it anyway, interviewing you, might as well.
It's all right. No, it's more of a family matter. My great-grandmother fell ill during last month, and I'm going there to take care of her.
All right. Well, anything you'd like to add? Last words, Liza, clearly you are a woman. You're sending the message, don't mess with me because I will fight back. That's what you're sending to everybody.
I just want to remind everyone to be respectful online. I want them to know that everything has consequences. Your actions, your words, they have consequences. And I believe in good and bad karma. If you do bad, then you will receive bad karma. If you do good, you will receive good karma. So it wouldn't hurt to be nice online. And I also want to remind people that rape is not a joke and it shouldn't be taken lightly. I hope that I never see any tweet or Facebook post or anything on social media about people joking about rape, because I hope that people will start becoming courageous to speak up or to stand up for themselves if they have the opportunity and the means to do so, of course.
All right, Liza, I want to thank you for agreeing to our interview. It's been such a pleasure speaking with you. You're a fresh voice. Thank you so much, Liza. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Paul.
All right, thank you, and have a safe trip and stay strong. Attorney June, thank you so much for joining us this morning too, sir.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
All right, God bless you both.